Hey, I'm Mr. Mardu, and welcome to the first video of this budget deck tech series, where we look to build viable decks whilst also looking after our wallets. Today we're talking about Death Ritual, a mid-range beatdown deck that wins by attacking the opponent's life total through combat and indirect damage effects. My current win rate with this deck is around 67%, and it comfortably got me to a reasonable 16 wins during last weekend's rank mode, where I started off in Auric Gold. Before we get into the deck tech, let's look at the guidelines we've set to define a budget deck. Everyone's budget is different, so we've listed four key guidelines which will help form the foundation of the decklist choices. Our starting point is to set a price limit for an individual card to be around $5, excluding gas fees. Cards will often cost significantly less than this, but that's our ceiling. Right now, we're avoiding the use of cards from the Genesis set, as the only way to acquire these cards at the moment is to pay a lot of money in gas fees. Once Genesis is released onto the IMX market, we can remove this guideline. Regarding core cards, the only way to get these at the moment is to get lucky and open them in packs. So to give new and mostly free-to-play players a chance, we're restricting the number of core epic and legendary cards per deck. Now with the guidelines out of the way, let's move on to the deck tech. If you're unfamiliar with Death Ritual, it's a god power for death and costs 2 mana to give one of your creatures +1/-1 and also heals your god for 2. Our plan is to play creatures with high health and beef them up with our god power, trying to beat down our opponent and also chip away at their life total with cards like Skull Scepter and Brimstone. Usually when people play death, they are committed to an aggro plan by playing Soulburn, but here we are able to continue grinding through the mid game thanks to our life gain ability. Let's start by looking at our creatures. We're playing 25 in this list, and we're mainly working with creatures that have either 3 health or above, so that we have room to use our god power, and also to dodge leech life nature decks, which is pretty big in the meta right now. In the early game, we have creatures like Pyreshell Beetle and Skeleton Heavy, who are great attackers, but we're also running a couple of copies of Vrock, which is great because it enters as a 4-3 and replaces itself by drawing a card. We can then pump it up to a 5-2 on the next turn so that it can either do a lot of damage to our opponent's god or comfortably trade with most early creatures, but also draws another card when it dies. It also draws cards for our opponent, but I found it very useful to keep us on curve as 2/3 of our deck costs 3 mana or less. Now onto one of our star cards of the deck, we have both copies of Undead Chimera, which is a good body on its own but really shines by doing 2 damage to both gods, both when it enters and also every time it attacks. By the time it's made its first attack, it's already done 4 damage, so even if it runs into a beefy frontline creature, it's still made value. And if you manage to get both copies on the battlefield at the same time, your opponent is in serious trouble, as you're automatically making them lose 4 life per swing. Undead Chimera is an essential piece of our deck, because we need to win the game before control players are able to take over the game with their late game bombs. We're also playing one copy of Fickle Cambion, which grows whenever we gain or lose life, so it becomes a real problem for our opponent if it's left unchecked. It's a 3 mana creature, but generally try and wait until turn 5 to play it so that you can use Blood Ritual to trigger its ability at least once. Otherwise it's just a 3-3 and could be a sitting duck for your opponent's next turn. Lastly, we're playing one Soul Charlatan, which is a little slow as it does nothing on the turn that it's played, but its ability means that we're able to keep creatures on the board by replacing them with 3/2 experimental outcomes. If it's able to survive at least a couple of turns, the engine really gets going, so this automatically becomes a number one target for your opponent to deal with. For defense, we're running 4 creatures with frontline like Minotaur Phalanx to stem the bleeding from life that we may have lost from earlier on in the game. Other than combat damage, we also have some sources of direct damage. Our other star card of the deck is Skull Scepter, which is a 2 mana relic that will ping your opponents for 1 each time one of your creatures die. This becomes particularly scary for your opponent in the mid to late game, as you should have been successful in attacking their life total in the first few turns. You're then relatively safe to commit creatures to the board and dodge board wipes, as the damage could be enough to finish your opponent off. Despite being so scary, I've noticed that people aren't running many sources of relic removal in their deck. So if you're proactive in taking relic removal cards from the Sanctum, then Skull Scepter should stick around for quite a few turns and deal a surprising amount of damage. We also have a Bombfly, which is great at getting that last 3 damage in, or even 4 if you've got a Skull Scepter in play. There's been a fair few times where I've closed out a victory by playing Bombfly and then killing it with Blood Ritual to finish off our opponent. Our last creature to call out is Dark Maniac, which is mainly here as a way to deal with Shadow of Lephanon, but will also ping the opponent, especially if their board is clear. And lastly at the top end, we've got one copy of Cyclops Marksman and one copy of Anubian Usher. These are just big creatures that are great to drop at the end of late game. And again, if you Blood Ritual them, they'll do a lot of damage. If budget isn't a concern, we have a couple of premium upgrades to consider. You could add in two copies of Pyramid Warden, subbing out one copy of Skeleton Heavy and one copy of Maya Bloodworm. Pyramid Warden is a great 2-drop, that's a 2-6 frontliner to protect your early life total, but you can also Blood Ritual it to get some extra damage in. You could also sub in one copy of Dangerous Ritual and take out one copy of Brimstone. Dangerous Ritual costs one extra mana, but it's effectively a double Brimstone as it deals 4 damage to each god and then again replaces itself, so it's great at getting that damage in. And lastly, we've got one copy of Avatar of Death, which will replace our copy of Cyclops Marksman. Avatar of Death is a 6 mana 6-6 that gets plus 1 strength for each point of damage your god takes, and also when it dies it will do 6 damage to a random enemy creature. This will double up as a removal spell after your opponent decides to target it. Now that's the end of the deck tech part of the video, so let's get on with the gameplay. Okay, so we've got 2 Dockside Prowlers and a Vrock. We're playing against Magic Bolt. Hidden could be quite useful, so let's keep these.
Where to begin?
Good luck.
Okay, so it's going to take until turn 2 to play the Mage Bolt, so we'll go with the Beetle first. Did debate to use a Bag of Tricks there, but we decided against it. Okay, they played the Felid Protector, so they've got frontline. So we can either play the ritual to get rid of the frontline creature, or let's see how much damage this does. 2 damage, yeah, so we could use a Bag of Tricks and play Vrock to get some early cards. Do quite like that play, so I think I'll do that. Okay, we drew a Fickle Cambion. Okay, so they've buffed their protector, so we will survive this turn. Unless they attack with it, of course. But we're okay with that, we'll draw a card. Oh, we've got a Skull Scepter, so key piece of our deck. So with a Skull Scepter, anytime one of our creatures dies, we'll ping them for 1. They really like this, so we're gonna play that straight away. They're probably gonna Mage Bolt us. Get rid of the Beetle. I think we'll play the Prowler for now. It's hidden. Do we care too much about the Felid Genasseri? No, I think we care about the life totals. We don't want to get to the late stages of the game in case they're playing a control style deck. Okay, yep, so they bolted the Beetle. They'll lose the damage.
Let's make them suffer.
Yeah, again, still don't really care about the 2-1. We're ideally waiting for turn 5 to play the Fickle Cambion because we want to be able to buff it with the Blood Ritual as soon as it comes down. I think we'll go Blood Ritual. Hit for 3. Play another Prowler. And that gives us 1 mana left over, so we might as well use the Brimstone. See what else we've got.
That's enough.
Undead Chimera. Perfect.
Let's see if I can find some order in this chaos.
So this is a 3 mana 3-5. There's a raw effect of dealing 2 damage to both players, but also every time we attack, it does 2 damage to each player. So it's a real key card of our deck. So as long as we keep our life total higher than theirs, we're in a good position.
At last.
Okay, so I think
think we go to Blight Bomb here. Yeah, Chimera. Get for more damage. We want to make sure that they're on a lower life total than us.
This ought to be entertaining.
So because we've got the Skull Scepter, it's a pretty good trade because they're paying 3 mana to kill one of our creatures or deal 2 damage, and then we're doing 1 damage to their life total. So again, it's actually working in our favour. Yeah, so we'll go for the Cambion here. Yeah, so whenever it gains, God gains health, it will gain 1 health, and then when we lose, it gains 1 strength. So if we play Blood Ritual here, it'll become a 4-2, but then it will gain a health from the life gain, so it'll be back up. So we'll do that. Gets it out of Major Bolt range.
I value my personal space beyond all else.
Suffer.
Interesting. So do we want a 5-3? They would already trade. We could trade and then do the Feral Shapeshifter to get rid of Tefeli Genasseri. I'm kind of scared about what other creatures they've got though. So I think what we do is we could play the Dark Maniac. It's going to be a Sacrificial Lamb, so we're going to Blood Ritual this guy. Ah, oh, miscalculated. So yes, still 4-4. They're going to trade, aren't they? That was a misplay. Okay, let's offer the trade.
How curious.
So we could play the Feral Shapeshifter, deal 2 damage to the Unbridged Assailant, but still not going to be dead. So what do we offer here? Yeah, I think we go Shapeshifter, kill Genasseri, play the Beetle.
I've seen much of the void, and I have no intention of returning.
So the opponent has 6 mana, got 6 cards in hand. Oh, okay, they've done 1 damage to the Beetle, probably going to bolt it. Yeah. No problem. We'll ping on them again, so they go down to 12. I think we want to play a creature this turn, so we'll kill the Unbridged Assailant first. They'll take a damage. And then we'll drop our frontline creature.
The cosmic scales must be kept in balance.
Okay, we've got a 1-1 wrap.
Let's make them suffer.
Okay, so we could... we'll do 1 damage, get him to 10. Drop the brawler. Regain some health.
Patience.
Okay, so I'll take 2 from the board wipe. Again, not too bad for us. The Skull Scepter's doing a lot of damage here. Right, Bombfly, this is great as a finisher, because as soon as this dies, it will do 3 damage to each god, but also another damage from the Skull Scepter. So we're halfway there. So I think here we'll drop the big guy and the fly.
Your undead would make for some very
so we've got lethal on board. They can't bolt the fly, or they can, but it would be great for us. Even a board wipe would be okay here.
Now you've got my attention.
Okay, so they're playing the Tome Golem, so they've drawn another 4 cards, so they do have some options here.
Let's make them suffer.
Yeah, they're done. So we'll go in for the damage. Might as well lose this guy. And then, as the finisher, the Bloodroot Roaring Bombfly to kill it. And bolt the opponent. And that's game.
And that brings us to the end of today's video. I had a lot of fun recording this deck, so let me know in the comments section what you think of it. Or let me know of any changes that you're thinking of making. Also, let me know if there's anything else that you'd want to see as part of this budget deck tech series. If you'd like to see more MTG and Gods and Chain content, don't forget to subscribe to help me grow the channel.